So after getting to bed at around about 7 o'clock, I got a nice solid sleep in an actual single bed in a room. So I got a really good sleep at the B&B in Galena. So I got up, I think, around about 1:30, sorted everything out, had a good breakfast, a few cups of coffee, got everything packed and ready to go. So I think I'll sort of recorded the first little video at the B&B at around about 2:30, and then from there pretty much went out, sorted everything, got dressed, out onto the, or out into the village, down along the roads, and then onto the river. So it was another cold morning. It was probably around another 5 or 10 degrees cooler on the river. So I think it was around about -15 to -25, maybe even colder. But coming from a warm start with a good breakfast and some coffee, it wasn't too bad because you're already warm. And then you get out there and you just sort of adjust your layers as you need to. So it was off to a good start. So I knew I had about 50 miles or 80 k's to cover until I got to Nulato. And there we're going to stay in a church with one of the, with a father there or a brother. So I wasn't too sure where it was. We knew as we got close, we just asked in the village and they'd direct us to it. And there we go. So got out, really nice, clear morning. The trail was actually quite good for this day. So based on the first couple of hours making really good time, I knew that there was a really good chance I'd be able to get to Nulato before the sun went down, which would be ideal because that would allow me to sort of sort everything with a bit of light, get into bed early, and then prep for the next day down to Caltag, because again that's another 40 miles. So I knew backing up 2 days was going to be a pretty big task. So got out, got onto the river, really nice day, it was nice and sunny. I had nowhere near the fatigue that I had the day before. So heading into Galena, I was really tired because it's such a shit sleep on the Yukon River, and now that I'd had a better sleep and I'd fed, I actually felt really good. So I knew the previous day that it was transient, and now today I wasn't suffering. I felt really good. I was quite confident I could go the distance. I'd done over halfway, so now it was just continuing to just take off those chunks every day as I could. So I knew if I, the way I was going, I'd be able to get to Nome. So I wasn't really too concerned about being able to get there. I was just making sure that I didn't make any mistakes around the cold weather. So as I was going down the river, I was sort of planning out my lunches or planning out my meal ahead. So as I sort of ate one meal, I'd make sure I'd got the next meal ready, put it in the pockets, made sure everything was thawing out as I went so that it was minimal piss farting around when it came time to eat. And then I'd sort of, as I'd go along, I'd just eat out of a pocket. So I was constantly taking in food, constantly taking in water out of my camelback, sort of a spare 2 liters of hot water that I'd filled up. So I knew that was still going to be hot that night. So when I got into Nulato, I knew I still have hot water. I could sort of let that cool and put in my camelback as I needed to. So again, it was sort of a day where I was walking with the other two racers and we're kind of a mile or two apart. We sort of spoke a little bit here and there, but for the most part, you're still alone with your thoughts. So you're still just walking along, just sort of thinking to yourself, trying to work out how fast you're going, how far or how long it's going to take you to get to the next checkpoint, you know, how long you got to lunch. So you just sort of get through the morning, get to lunch, and then from lunch you sort of get through the afternoon, and then you sort of timing and distance. You sort of keep yourself occupied on the river by looking at the corner, sort of trying to work out how far ahead it is and whether that's going to take you 2 hours to get to that corner and get around it, or what that's going to look like. So as the sort of day went on, sun started coming down, I started to close in on Nulato. So I was only a couple of miles out, and it was kind of nice heading in there sort of thing. So just before we went on the approach in, it kind of went around a little bit of a corner, and it just sort of took about 2 hours to get around that corner, but I eventually came around and I sort of hit the village right on sunset. Beautiful sort of scenery as I came in, went up, sort of walked into the village, had a bit of a look around, and I think one of the other racers was a bit ahead of me and then the other one was a little bit behind. So I sort of followed the first racer in, and then he kind of got directed around a little bit from some villages, so I followed him. We found where we thought the checkpoint was. The guy we were supposed to meet wasn't there, and the guy that was there told us he wasn't interested sort of thing, so he sent us to the town hall. So went around there. It had got dark now. Town hall was heated. It had everything we needed. It had hot water, had a warm place to sleep. It was inside sort of thing. So we got in there about 9, 10 o'clock. Again, had a heap of food, a heap of water, some hot drinks, sorted everything out, redid everything I needed to the next day, and then tried to work out how much sleep I needed, how much sleep I could get, and just sort of look at what time I needed to get up to make the 40 miles to Caltag in one hit. So I worked out if I was in bed by 11, up around about 5, then I could Caltag out the next day. So from there, it was sort of getting my head down, getting a good sleep. Really happy with the work I'd done this day, or on day 16. So done the 50 miles or 80 k's in around about 18 or 19 hours, which was pretty solid work. So I was happy with that. And now it's time to get some rest, try and get in another solid day come day 17.